today. I'm going to try to sheet this short end of the shower room here with some galvanized metal. I'm going to do some temporary plumbing I got in the back of my room. We're about to leave out and go do some logs here. I'll get my plumbing out the way. I like to use Teflon tape on threaded connections and then go back over it with some record seal. top. Go inside and get the PEX pipe on the other side. Turning on me. See if we got water. Sand. Usually I pre-drilled the holes in my metal. Seeing how I didn't have a lot going on this side, I just didn't choose to do it today. But I am going to use a level to line them all up. Make them look good. Fine gloves necessary, but it's hard to work with sometimes. In case some of y'all wondering, it may not even show up after editing, but our videos kind of bounce around from project to project. That's mainly because the Holy Spirit leads us to go volunteer somewhere, or kind of on call with some people, and they ask me to come. They're good people, I'm not going to tell them no, so I kind of pull up, I'll get to breaking off point and I'll go. That's why today I'm focusing on this, because I'm leaving to go to Baton Rouge. And I had to quit with my siding because it's more dried in on that side. So need to get this covered up because I may be gone for a few weeks. So it's not that we're all spacey and jumping around. Not completely the reason anyway. This is also part of our mission, but it's not top priority, I should say. Go cut a piece of metal. Alright. Yeah, good idea. Brace home off of there and it ought to work fine. Oh yeah. Trim will go up here and cover that and it fits like a glove. This one's going to have a couple extra screws in it because we'd used it previously and took it back down when we decided to combine these two small buildings. So I'm going to fill the holes with a screw. Metal down, that'll look like new. That driver's wore out. Piece of wood trim to go on that side. Only need a piece of metal because the trim's going to cover that side of the door. Fill my corner out, chest watering. If you're wondering why the hose bib's so high, there's gonna be a deck right here and a storage box right here. We want it high enough over it. Plus I like stuff high because I ain't the shortest person. And it worked out good with the interior plumbing, so there you have it. Start building our corners. All right, back to put some trim on. Made up some L's out of this rough cut tree stuff.
I'm using for the siding and all the trim. This one's not actually a corner. You'll have to put the front pieces on it to make it a corner. That'll come in due time. Whenever I can remember to do it, a little trick I like to do on this exterior stuff is run the screws up in at an angle. That way, any water goes in the screw hole, it's more likely to drain out. Another one. Should be done in the middle of it there. side, but that'll hold it for now. Check it out. Charlie, come check it out. A little bit of rodent blocking in these corners so they can't use it to climb up to the top. little bit up in here. Move on to trimming around that front window. A little piece of trim goes up there, but worry about that when I'm up there putting the soffit in. That's got it dried in where the rain can't get on the OSB or anything. Just a little bit of silicone work and it'll be done.